Hi Power Guys, in this video I am gonna show you how to use Power Automate to copy a file from OneDrive to Azure File Storage and further processing the file through Data Factory. So let's jump in and see how to do.
First of all, we have to copy the geography file in OneDrive, as you see here. Once this file is uploaded, we will go to the flow. Here you see the simple flow. You can name it according to your requirements. And then you see these four objects, which is recurrence. I am doing scheduling per day to run it on a daily basis, then list files in the folder. You can add a dynamic content as well. Get the file content. So getting that same file content in this object. So second one is listing the files, third one is getting the file content, and fourth one is creating a connection to the Azure file storage. So this value you see here is a dynamic value, and then create file. This is a connection to Azure file storage. You have to specify the folder path, the file name, and the file content. So file name and file content, these are the dynamic items from here, right hand side if you see. Now if you see, this operation uploads a file to Azure file storage. Similarly, the third one shows this operation gets the contents of a file. This operation gets the list of files and subfolders. And this one is just a trigger on a daily basis, triggers an event. Now let's see the connection details of Azure file storage which I have created. Go to data and then connections. You will see all the connections here. Click on Azure file storage. You will see all the details of this connection here. The apps using this connection, the flows using this connection. And as you can see, this is a premium connector. The description of this connector is given here. The owner, status, created and modified date. If you click on edit, you will see the display name which you have given. You can choose any name as per your wish, as per your requirements. Then you have to give the Azure storage name, the file storage name here, and the Azure account access key, the account access key for the particular storage account which you have given above. So by this you will be able to access the storage account. Now if we go back, we can go back to the flow. Is a flow checker and test option here. So flow checker will give no errors. If it is okay, then we can perform the test. Now if we click on test, the files will get copied from OneDrive to the Azure file storage. Now if I show you, these are the various steps it will go through, and this is the Azure file storage. So once I click test there, the file will get copied here to the Azure file storage. So if you see here at the top, I have written, this is the tool for the exploring the Azure storage, and the same file is copied here. Now from Data Factory, the processing of that file is happening. So first I'm copying the file from that blob storage to Azure Virtual Machine data disk to a specific folder location. So if you see here, source and sync datasets are being defined. In the source dataset, I have defined the blob location, and sync dataset is the Azure Virtual Machine. shared drive path. If I open this connection, you will see here the linked service shows the Azure file storage connection details. And then sync dataset, it will show you the linked service of file server. So I have specified a default path and a string variable. I'll not go in much details. So if I execute that copy path alone, the file will get copied here. This is the shared drive path. So getting the folder metadata as the next step, filtering the CSV files. All the CSV files in that particular folder will get filtered, and then there is a for each loop. So suppose there are 5 files present in that folder, so this for each loop will execute 5 times. And inside this for each loop, I am executing another pipeline just for the purpose of processing the data. I'll not go in each and every detail of this Azure Data Factory pipeline, but just to showcase what can be done. I'm passing various parameters here in this pipeline. Checking the process flag, getting the metadata, lookup columns, setting up the variables, if conditions, all those things I'm doing here. So this is what I wanted to show you guys, like these steps we can follow and do this simple copy paste from online storage location to a blob storage, and then finally through blob to a